Greetings. This is video number 9 in the series comparing Christianity to Islam, and the third describing what Islam says about Christianity. In the last video, we talked about several interesting errors in the claims Islam makes about Christians and Jews. For example, Jews and Christians are called polytheists by the Quran. Clearly, this is wrong. No sane person can call Jews polytheists. In this video, I'm going to address several interesting aspects of Islam as it pertains to the people of the book and the message of the book. First, realize Islam is the last major religion on earth, and it began roughly 600 years after the death of Jesus on the cross. This is the most widely recorded and historically established event in ancient history. Islam is the only new religion of global consequence since Jesus was crucified and raised from the dead. So when Islam began, Christianity had already been growing for 600 years. Islam presented itself as a follow-on to Christianity, which means it claimed a relationship. But Islam also has an agenda, which is clearly to subvert and supplant and ultimately destroy Christianity. Observation 1. Outside Judaism and Christianity, there is only one other religion mentioned by name in the Quran, Sabians, and only once. All other religions are lumped into the generic term pagans and infidels. But this begs the question. While Islam is lumping all other religions as pagans and infidels, how can it claim Allah sent messengers and scriptures and established Ummah in every nation? In fact, when challenged, those in Islam will readily claim religions that it calls pagan were started by Allah. Case in point, Hinduism. Observation 2. Islam claims to confirm the Torah and Christian scriptures, but is lacking many fundamental teachings of those documents. The Quran does not contain the list of the Ten Commandments. The Quran says nothing about the Levitical feasts that God Himself ordained. The Quran does not know the history of God's covenant with Abraham. The Quran does not know or contain the Sermon on the Mount by Prophet Jesus. This begs the question, can the Quran be relied upon to confirm and restore and correct a message it simply does not comprehend? Observation 3. Islam tries to speak against Christian doctrines, but never speaks against the doctrines of any other religion. I'm willing to admit, I'm wrong. If someone in Islam can point out surah and ayat that names another religion and refutes a specific doctrine. Observation 4. Islam claims to confirm Christian scriptures, but then speaks against the following doctrines of Christianity. Original sin. The three-part nature of God, i.e. the Trinity. The crucifixion of the Son of God. Forgiveness for sin. Assurance of salvation. And ultimately, eternity in the presence of a holy God. And Islam loses the historical concept of sin revealed by the prophets. Islam has no concept of the Passover and the Passover lamb. And Islam has no concept, no revelation, no understanding of the nature of sin. In fact, Islam downplays the significance of sin. Just say the Shahada and all your sins are forgiven. So we are completing our examination of what Islam says about Christianity. And I think you should pay attention to the differences in the messages between the two religions. Is it possible that Islam could truly be a follow-on revelation related to the message of Christ and Christianity? You can, of course, form your own opinion, but the correct answer is not by any stretch of the imagination. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. I think this provides a reasonable summary of what Islam says about Christianity and Judaism.